entrepreneurship. It's incredibly diverse and incredibly individualistic. So that doesn't really tell the story. Or it's this, can I order a beer? Or it's this.
I'm sorry.
Israel, can you introduce yourself, please?
I'm Sarah Lacey, and I'm a columnist for Business Week, and I co-host Tech Ticker, which is a sort of highly produced video blog on Yahoo Finance. And I have my own blog, and I have a book that's coming out in a couple weeks.
Okay. The same folks who are trying it again, or is it a new generation of entrepreneurs?
It's mixed, and I wanted to really get a deep sense of who these people are and what drives them, because I think. Came to the Valley in the late 90s, and you're in your 20s and had no experience, made billions. You can't really believe you're good either. So there's this, and there's so much anger towards the .com. So anyway, and I remember where I was. So it's either, you know, this very specific portrait which hardly tells anything about the nature of entrepreneurship, or it's this big composite that also doesn't tell anything because it doesn't give anything personal about what it's really like to be that guy in that situation and that pressure.
Thank you.
Mark Zuckerberg, of all of the people in my book, is the one who has the strongest internal compass, because he has known from the beginning what Facebook was going to be. And, you know, he used to belabor these handwritten journals from the earliest days that would spell out every feature and everything he wanted to do. And it's not always even been something that he could articulate, but it's something he's gotten on a gut level. And he has this amazing mixture of being this gut-level CEO who's also really analytical. So, like, for instance, there's a whole section...
Empire Planté joue possibilité pour vendre pour abaille atelier Sayo. Ça qui est de l'argent entre notre poche Planté Sayo. Plus rapide.
Everyone knew it. It was a horrible IPO. It was this inside cover story called the IPO. IPO from hell, where they followed along with it, and it was brutal. And then everyone piled down on Andreessen, and they all said he made up or exaggerated his role with, you know, both Netscape and Mosaic. And everyone said that, you know, he was nothing without Jim Clark or Jim Barksdale, who had been his mentors. And I mean, everyone just turned on him. There's so much animosity towards the dot-coms because they had just shown up old economies, and old economies were just dancing on their grave.